So we'll be presenting Ypsilanti plus 30, Jeff Duby, Brad Casberg, and Yossi Kuroda. So we have come up with a plan based on four main groups of axons and how we'll be talking through them each based on how they affect the broader context of Ypsilanti. First, the current trends in Ypsilanti, there's some problems happening. Low income, low life expectancy, high obesity, other health problems. But there's also a lot of good things happening, like interest in art and culture, local food, and Ypsi pride, which we think is a very big thing. And so this diagram here shows how we perceive things to be really connected. So doing one thing like open space enhancement can lead to multiple different things throughout, and each of these really affect everything else. So we conceptualized this into four basic concepts: sense of place, including centeredness, amenities, developments, economics, small businesses, social well-being, food security, health, and civic engagement, Ypsi pride. We'll start by talking about how sense of place affects all the other things.
Awesome, thank you, Ishii. And one key strategy that we have is to build a stronger center. In Ypsilanti, there definitely is a strong sense of place, but we do think there are a couple of opportunities to enhance that and begin to examine the multiplying effect that some of these design interventions can have on small business improvement, sense of place, and Ypsi pride, as well as the arts community as well. So here we're proposing changing two of the main arteries in the downtown area from one-way streets to two-way streets. This is shown to foster more of a downtown walkable environment that focuses more on sense of place and a local business environment rather than catering just to the automobile. A lot of these are set up in terms of creating an imageable system, to borrow Kevin Lynch's term, really where you can begin to understand Ypsi and the place around you, and that's connected and livable and creates a civic engagement where people enjoy where they're at, where it starts to promote health a little bit. And here, this may be more of a concept diagram, but we're proposing a greenway system that really engages the downtown area a little bit more. Currently, there is a lack of public space, and we want to address that by creating more of a system where people can begin to program these certain elements based on their needs and begin to reach out to the broader downtown development districts in terms of access, but then also that larger system that supports these multiple goals like small business improvement, etc.
Next, we'll talk about development, especially focusing in on small business, increasing the income of people so they can have a better life, building upon the Ypsi pride that they can do it, that they can make their lives better, and also creating a sense of place by having the community of small businesses popping up within the city. So Spark East is an incubator that is active in Ann Arbor as well as Ypsi, and they have an office right downtown on Michigan Avenue. So we want them to really captivate this movement towards small business, really filling in the spaces in downtown to bring a better community. This map here shows the red areas as existing used business areas locations. It shows that there's some gaps in the matrix in the central downtown area. So we want to really fill those in and make it a real more compact and full downtown area. And also using a bus loop system to really connect all four of the development districts to bring in more of the customer base into each of these areas, making sure that the small businesses can thrive.
So now we'll be talking about social well-being, talking about food security, improved health, affordability of the region, as well as increased income. And we're really interested in how the farmers market, as well as other parts of the downtown core, can provide avenues to support these components. First off, with the farmers market, really hitting home about the double up food bucks and extending that to as many people as possible. Also, providing the farmers market as a sort of business incubator on its own, potentially creating delivery services to people that are unable to travel, Very important to our design is creating affordable housing within the downtown corridor. It's important to create an inclusive, cohesive environment, and through the integration of the affordable housing with the greenway and with the extended public space, we hope to provide a stronger, more connected environment. All of this will lead to further civic engagement, so the pride that we talk about when we talk about Ypsi, encourage further activism, inclusion, as well as participation, which will then obviously feed back to everything else we've been talking about. One thing that we envision is a Ypsilanti Community Center. We've suggested this this space. It's not set in stone, but it's a perfect space because it's right downtown. It creates a cohesive environment with the farmers market, and it's a it repurposes a derelict building.
So referencing some earlier precedents that we had, all of these strategies really focus on creating a flexible environment downtown where people can really plug into either the local business community, and it really supports that as well, or people can start to engage with different areas of the city, and it's really an accessible area. And there's a strong sense of civic pride where there are communities and policies in place that really support support each other in an inclusive manner, such as the housing program and the artistic interest in the business community with Spark as well. So here's a general